Thank you very much. Well, in the given time of 5 minutes, I'll try to address 3 points about the potential of democracy in Georgian society, about the main obstacles of building a sustainable democracy, and about the approach we have now in Georgia, we meaning the new government which is responsible about the country since 2012. About the potential, after listening to this analysis, what was happening about democracy during the course of history and during the last 40 years and so on, for us Georgians, these last 40 years were instrumental. Why? Because, not because of the events in Portuguese, but because of the Helsinki process, which started almost in the same time. And we all know that that process generated very important processes in this country. When the people, the dissidents, emerged as the people who started penetrating democratic ideas in the society, which was in stagnation in Brezhnev era. And many political leaders who later on led the country to the change, a dramatic change, started their political activity or thinking in those days, including the founders of the party I belong, the Republican Party, which was founded in those years, 1978. Others formed different groups and so on. And that was the important ingredient of the process which we observed then in late 80s, when after Perestroika, this country emerged as, well, during the Perestroika years, this country emerged as one of the champions of fight against Soviet rule, fight against Soviet empire, and fight for joining the democratic world. This was a very important process which we observed, but would those leaders of different political groups and dissidents be able to, would be able to do that without having potential in the society? Probably no. And we need to underline very important feature, characteristics of our society, of our people. Georgians are very individualistic people. They want to be champions. Not only political leaders are fighting for the very few cheers in political leadership, but everything Georgian wants to be best. And those of you who know better the culture of Georgia, the last point is the competition who is making best homemade wine. And if you tell somebody that, no, probably your wine is not as good as the other one, well, that's the huge, huge humiliation of the people. So there could be a number of things brought in the discussion which demonstrate that, well, this country, this society cannot tolerate something different than democracy, than free competition, than the ability to kind of make your own case and to be you, not something which others want you to be. Therefore, authoritarian rule, which, yeah, in many countries lasted or is still the case for decades, probably in this country has a life expectation of 2, 3 years, 4 years, not more. And it has been demonstrated a couple of times during the last 25 years. So what I want to say, and we, because of time constraint, I cannot elaborate more, there's huge potential and spirit of the democratic lifestyle, and this is probably most natural for the society. But then we see that we have some obstacles, and we failed several times. At the beginning of 90s, we believed that when we said no to communist regime, well, democracy would arrive. That would be so easy. Because, yeah, now we all wanted freedom, and there were many parties, more parties than we have now in political scene, but it didn't work. Then there were several waves of this kind of transformation and expectations and hopes, last failure being the Rose Revolution, which generated huge enthusiasm, and most of the people I see in this room, Georgians, we are together in those days and then trying to achieve something, including all of us, Georgians here, in different capacity. But then some things happened, and then we are now in all different sides, and then we are sometimes fighting, and so why is that? Why we failed to stay together when we were so close to each other? Probably because we failed to disassociate our personality from the public roles we are having. To make sure that, well, when I am looking to my old friend, Mr. George Margolashvili, I am looking now to the president of the country. And no matter how I like him or dislike him or agree or disagree on the personal level, I need to agree with this fact that he's the president, and I'm talking with the president. And he is the president. And Mr. George Baromidze, with whom I have a longer history of being together and fighting together, I need to agree that he is vice speaker of the parliament, and he is member of the parliament. And no matter how much I disagree to him, or I have many questions about his decisions in the past and so on, yes, we need to somehow work together. I need to listen to him, and I need to take into account his arguments, and sometimes agree as well. And that's not shame. That's why I say that, yeah, on this issue, he's right. So this goes to political culture issue. This goes to some temperament or many other things. And I find this as main obstacle, because we fail to consolidate our potential. We fail to institutionalize our democratic potential. We fail sometimes to have free and fair competition between political parties. On the other hand, we succeed becoming kind of enemies. On the second day, after we disagree on some issue, on policy issue or on a value issue or something like that. So that's major obstacle which we need to overcome, and there are many tools how it should be done, and so on, and how to consolidate democratic forces in this country, how to make sure that we can live together even when we disagree to each other and move forward. And third point I wanted to make is the approach of the new political leadership we have now in this country. Some years ago, there was huge debate, discussion inside the country, what was going on. Because there were, well, according to our colleagues from now opposition, then ruling party, there was a great process of building Georgian state. And therefore, certain shortcomings, mistakes, some other problems, they were justified with this very noble and very needed process, building the state. But the problem, I believe, was that the process of building the state and process of building the authority or the system of authority, state authority, were mixed. And probably in most cases we had the we were observing the process of building state authority and the system of authority, how to govern the country and how make it effective, then building a state. Because building a state is much more complex process than building effective authority. And that's the case, that's true, that previous government was much more effective than we are now. They succeeded in building effective system of authority, state authority. Even when Mr. President mentioned the word effectiveness, the microphone failed today. That's quite symbolic. So we, our government, are less effective. Why? I believe because we try to build the state. And if you want to build the state, you need to agree that institutions must be developed. And we should better allow judges make mistakes, then try to guide them every time and make sure that they are not making mistakes. Therefore, they are effective, they are making fast decisions, which are in the line of the policy of the government, and everything moves faster. We better allow local governments be not well prepared at the moment for dealing with their jobs, and allow people to elect their own mayors, which we did during the last local elections. And yeah, they are not as effective as those who were appointed a few years ago and who were watched from the center and who were guided from the center. And yeah, they were able to solve some problems faster. But if we do not allow local people to be free and to make sometimes mistakes as well, they will never learn how to govern with their village and so on. Again, I will not continue more. This is our approach, that if we want to build state, we need to strengthen the institutions, and we need to allow that president is the president, and he has his mind, and sometimes we disagree, and sometimes he will put veto on the law which the parliament adopts, which was unthinkable previously. If during the previous system, one minister would say something differently, or one institution would act differently than state hierarchy worked. That was the start of the end, because the monolithic structure of the governance would be just destroyed. I'm not saying that this approach is perfect. Of course, we have problems, and we need to improve in terms of democracy, in terms of rule of law, in terms of transparency, but this is the approach. And we better spend more time on building real state and state institutions than being too much focused on today's needs, that we need to build this road, or we need to, I don't know, deliver this service to the people, no matter what is the cost in terms of democratic development. So this is the challenge, and I believe we will be successful, because we have learned a lot of things from our past. Thank you.
Mr. Speaker.